A penalty. They've got the ball again, first and 10 inside the 20-yard line. A passing offense is what we'll expect to see tonight, and good look so far from them. This is David Hoslong, Randy McCoy, and heavy block on camera. We're a little slow getting out. Technical difficulties. Sorry about that, but we're back here at French Field. Greeley Central visiting the Fort Collins Lambkins. Homecoming tonight for the Lambkins, and right now their defense is back on its heels. The ball inside the 14-yard line, second and 4 for Central. Right now, Randy, we're seeing a red-hot Escamilla throwing the ball around, and right now he's got them on the move.
Well, he's thrown for almost 1,000 yards so far this year, so that's what he do.
He's got a lot of open field in front of him right now. He
Boy,
should
what
score.
What a good-looking athlete.
Yeah, and he puts his shoulder in, do smartly his left one. Gets down inside about the 2-yard line. And, I mean, he's got a couple. I mean, I just let out an oh my on the kickoff because the number 88, Donovan Salazar, showed some extremely fast wheels and took it across for about 70 yards. And he had a catch here a minute ago. So Greeley Central came to play. Even though they're 0-5, it might be easy to overlook them, but they've showed up so far.
Well, 0-5, Fort Collins coming in 1-4. First conference game of the year for both these teams.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we apologize. Had some computer issues here. So you didn't miss much. You missed a good return, but other than that, we're
snapped
good.
Directly to the running back, number 17. Jordan Cervantes takes it in for the touchdown. So Greeley kind of goes a little offset plan there, just a little wildcat. Cervantes takes it in. So 6-0 early going, 8:30 left here in the first quarter. And Fort Collins has not even been on the field with the offense. PAT pending now. Kick is up and it is good.
That's Yackey on the kick.
You were just waiting to say that, weren't you?
I was just.
Yeah, it's definitely, there's no chance for mispronunciation, although we may have a couple of challenges as the night goes on. Apologize ahead of time. We've been trying to find out how to get some pronunciations. We are here for every kid out there playing. We are a Fort Collins-based Poudre School District group, but we know all these athletes are out here to compete. There's only, you know, maybe one town a little further down the front range that we may not cheer for that much, but,
yeah.
You know, rhymes with Boulder.
But we'll appreciate the efforts all.
What a beautiful night here to play. For those of you who couldn't make it over to Greeley Central, watching your kids take that opening drive after a long return on the opening kickoff and put it right down the throat of the defense of the Lambkins and kind of took the crowd out. People still filling in here. Nice student turnout, and as you'd expect on homecoming night, Friday night lights here. Chamber of Commerce football weather, that's for sure. First game earlier today, Poudre got out to a big lead on Fountain Fort Carson, and then Carson rallied back and made it a game, and Poudre still won by 4.
That's a great kickoff.
Yeah, pinned it right down on the side of the 5. Got a little bit of an angle now. He's going to get to the outside. Returner for the Lambkins is going straight forward. He's got one block to miss. He's cut all the way across back. It's just going to be a foot race, and he's got the gas, and he's going to get caught. But what a great hustle play for the for Greeley Central, number 9 of us, 98 or 92. 92 saved the touchdown. Eric Hernandez never gave up on the play because Michael Cadlick probably ran about 110 yards and got the ball across inside the 40-yard line in Central. So two big returns to open the game for both teams. So first and 10 now. Erickson brings him out. Pistol formation, two wideouts both sides. Blitz right away. He's going to get caught, spun down. Actually gets out of a couple tackles. He's got the Central kids all over him.
Erickson over 1,000 yards passing. Top passer in the area.
Yeah, loss about 8 there on first down. Brings up second and 18. Got to get inside the 30-yard line. Toss sweep right. Heading upfield. Nice job that time, just getting a little bit of yardage backed up there, but a nice run. Connor McGraw takes it around the corner and positive yardage back, makes the third and about 12. Lamb can certainly want to answer that opening drive touchdown by the Wildcats from Greeley Central. Snap back to Erickson, looks, he's got a man over the little center screen. Actually caught off the ground. Stead downfield, gets a block. He's got a lot of yardage. Yeah, inside the 10, the 15, 20, spins off a couple tackles, takes it to the house. Jackson Shore bobbles the catch a little bit behind him, goes down, takes it off his shoelaces, a la Franco Harris, bounces off two or three tackles in the secondary and takes it into the end zone. What a great individual effort. And that's how you answer if you're the Lambkins.
Well, and by the looks of that, we may have a shootout tonight.
Yeah, it's when it starts off, that fever goes.
Fort Collins scored 42, I believe, last week.
So the PAT is up and good. We have a report down at Cherry Creek tonight. Fossil Ridge visiting Cherry Creek. And they are down early, 21-0. So a tough night down there with, as expected, a very good foe.
There you see the cheerleaders for Fort Collins Lambkins, live from French Field here. Late start, 7:30 start tonight. There is a Lambkin sighting.
Yeah, our first of the day. We usually get a few more of the looks. I didn't have an Impala earlier, never saw one. But what a great night for football. And if you're the Lambkins, you had to answer that. Now, I think the question is, do you kick it back to the very dangerous Donovan Salazar, number 88? I mean, we don't want to miss any plays, but boy, to watch that young man, he accelerated down the sideline and barely got caught from taking it all the way. Collins breaks their huddle, as they want to do. They practice that, and sometimes that will be an onside kick. You've got to honor that. They got a little of that riverboat gambler in them. Approaches the kick, is going to be taking it back. Salazar takes it to his 8-yard line. Looks for a space to go. Is trying to bust the outside. Nice solid tackle. About the 23-yard line, he goes down. So the Wildcats will start off there, first and 10.
Number 34 for Fort Collins, Jace Whitey is on the tackle.
Jace Whitey had the tackle there too. It was just a good, solid special teams tackle. And as coaches will say, you like the form tackle and you want it in, but whatever you get him down, especially somebody as dangerous runner as Salazar, you've got a good job done. First and 10, trips right side. Quarterback looks downfield, fires the deep out, caught, 32-yard line, gain of about 7. Second pass reception there for number 11, Xavier Bonham. Between Bonham and Salazar, two very fast wideouts. And the way they're going to throw the ball tonight, as we talked about before, I mean, Escamilla, Randy, you know, he's got plus 1,000 yards already. Lampkins show blitz, bring it in, and just did a great job of the fill every lane gap integrity. Came through, and Captain Corey Lang got on top of Escamilla. There was just, they sent 7 or 8, and not enough to block them. So third and about 8, got to get out past 35-yard line for a first down. Thanks again for tuning in to Stream It Sports, streamitsports.com/PSD. If you notice there on your screen, there all the defensive linemen for Collins are all standing up, little stunt play, twisting around, trying to confuse the offensive linemen. And a nice throw, but a good break on the ball, and an excellent play by the defensive back over there, Shea Wind. I think if he'd been on the other sideline, he might have got some complaints by the coaches. One arm across, one arm on the hug. But the official was right there. He liked the timing on it, so it must have been good. So back to punt for the Wildcats, number 17, Cervantes. Time is stopped. We get a timeout on the field taken by the Lambkins. They might have been missing one player or had some kind of a equipment issue, so they'll join it all together. Not the time you want to make a mistake, obviously, in a game. Job here tonight, the Collins band, the cheerleaders, the Palm Squad, dance squad, everybody's out. Homecoming night, oldest high school here in Fort Collins. Bunch formation now for that punt. Single setback for the Lambkins. Real long delay on the kick. Rugby styles, it takes it straight downfield. It's going to bounce and go there. Grab, though, out of the air. Rather dangerous. And a great effort downfield by the Wildcats, number 27, Dylan Hadar. Hader, probably, excuse me, but he did a great job of just staying right on top of Cadlick. And Cadlick saved probably 10, 15 yards by just pulling the ball and grabbing it. I think he almost got away, but the jersey couldn't get loose. 5:13 left here in the first quarter. Second game of a doubleheader here tonight at French Field. Poudre School District Sports. Keeper by Erickson tries to go to the middle, picks his way around. Gang tackled by the Wildcats, gain of about four. Brings up a second and five. Shore split wide out the top of your screen. Single receiver inside, tight end right. Two backs in the set in the shotgun. Erickson fakes. Faked out the defensive end. He's got the edge. He's going to step up field and then just aims for the line to gain. We'll see on the spot. Actually, the referee's going to say he stepped out just across the 40-yard line. So didn't have a chance to really hone in on where he had to go. Brings up a third and two. But great ball handling that time and had a chance to gain without even being touched. Uh-oh, and it was interception. I'll explain that in a second here, but Greeley Central, they're trying to run. They ran a fake bubble screen outside, try to run an inside screen and do a shovel pass. And Erickson had to throw it over the top of the lineman. The Greeley defender who sat on the play and saw it, just picked it up out of the air and returned it about 10 yards. This is gonna be first and 10 Wildcats on the 26-yard line of the Lambkins. So a broken play where you're trying to get rid of the ball and all of a sudden you realize the ball wasn't alone in the air. Nice job by the Wildcat defender to come and make that play diagnosis. That's gonna be a back to pass right away. And he's got nowhere to go. Nice job downfield in the coverage. I think one of those nights where you start seeing all these pass attempts and you'll have a defensive line that's either going to get tired or they're going to have to rotate them in and in and in.
Lots of three for Greeley Central.
So a timeout here at French Field with 5:12 left to play here in the first quarter. It's tied at 7. You're watching Stream It Sports.
Who wants more peas?
Go away.
Oh, Daddy hates pop-up ads.
Go away.
Hashtag dinner time.
Scroll forward.
Show selfie. No!
Selfie.
Go forward.
Delete selfie.
Go away.
Send picture.
Bookmark.
No. Go away.
No, post photo.
Scroll up. Scroll forward.
Hashtag gravy.
Faster.
Go faster.
The First Bank mobile app. Technology has never been so easy.
We're back here after the timeout. I think we're a little behind on the scoreboard. They're showing no timeouts left for either team. But 5:12 left here in the first quarter. Wildcats after a loss on first down. They have a chance to make a point or two out of that turnover, Randy, and that's when all of a sudden that game turns. You got to take advantage of those mistakes. You know, they're 0-5, and we know that 1-4 Lambkins, but Lambkins have already played a couple of 5A teams. And traditionally, Coach Rice's teams have always improved.
Well, last couple of years, they haven't had that great of pre-conference seasons or records.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end, they always seem to be playing for the championship on the last weekend, right?
I don't know what we've got for an issue here because they've still talked a lot of discussion going on. It must be a scoreboard deal, but kind of like one of the assistant coaches for Lambkins is out talking to his kids, and he's talking to both the receivers for the Wildcats, too. Give him a little pat on the shoulder, you know, and away it goes. So we got an adjustment in the time now down to 4:50. Now we get a stoppage of play by the umpire. Apparently some clock issue, and we're just trying to find out what it is. Generally done here is we don't have mics on our officials here live, so they'll home coach will talk to his coaches, and they can relay that. So we went from 5 and change down to 4:52. As I mentioned, it shows no timeouts left for anybody, so I could have missed some, but I don't think I missed 6 total timeouts. Another score to report from down in Denver. Fossil Ridge on the road taking on one of the top teams and one of the top programs in the state, losing 21-0 right now to Cherry Creek. Now we're back ready to play. Clock is running under 4:45. The official likes it, so spread formation is committee back to throw. Steps up, steps around one man, looks downfield, finds a guy out in the center. Nice throw. We're going to get an interference call, too. I don't know if it would be the push-off or a hold, but Escamilla did a nice job just finding some time around there. And
good-looking athlete.
Yeah, he really is. And
he's just got that look, doesn't he?
Yeah. Well, and he's got big old 78 there in front of him, 6'7", and 338 pounds, Jonah West. He had to get around him just to see downfield.
And has a chance to... just move the ball. They spotted it a little short. I thought he got down to the 15-yard line, but not right there. Now we got an explanation going across. Holding. So holding call on the secondary, which is not an automatic first down, so they declined the penalty because it had gone back to the they actually got a better result from the play, so they took the play. Brings up third and short. Wildcats out now, pistol formation, two backs set aside of either side of Escamilla. Give running back slides to the right side. Easily gets the first down inside the 15-yard line. Nice drive. See, I'd get behind Jonah West too.
Yeah, we've seen guys look bigger than him, but I don't know that we've seen too many that are bigger than him.
Well, in a huddle that's got some big kids in it, he stands above everybody. And he looks like he moves pretty good. So
So first and 10 now, ball just inside the 15-yard line. Low snap, Escamilla tries to go out to his left, flips over the top, hits his running back, but really nowhere to go.
Picture perfect.
They're going to say the ball hit the ground. Lampkins have picked it up. They're going to take it all the way back. I was assuming he would have been down. So it's going to be a return of about 65 yards for the touchdown, maybe 70.
And then they threw a...
There's going to be a flag, a penalty. Some guys went off the bench to... Well, yeah, they're going to be kicking off from the parking lot. A little celebration penalty, I'm afraid. And it might have been a sideline warning, too, but you can't... Yeah. They had him tackled, spun around. And there's two penalties laying right out at the middle of the field.
So he must have spun around and lost the ball before he went down, or they just missed it.
I guess, yeah, because he looked like he was sitting down, you know, and he was certainly in the grass. But if he lost the ball, as you said.
And there is no replay, so.
Back it up when you get a chance on the DVR on Stream It Sports. Quick little highlight, though, too, is thanks to our ace reporter for the Lambkins, the Big E, Eric Sampson. Just very good softball here in the Poudre School District this year, and the Lambkins are representing, too. They got second in the Front Range League.
Personal foul.
And a push in the block in the back, so it's going to be first down, and, okay, they add them up. So they basically got the turnover where the turnover happened. And again, at a long run. So first and down, first and 10 now. Lampkins, 3:25 left here in the first. Erickson back in the pistol, three receivers right. Jet. Sweep coming around the side. Got the lane. Good chance to go outside. Just waiting for his blockers.
I was going to say he wasn't touched till
he got downfield about 12 yards. Great play call. Nice blocking down in front. Antonio Burgos showed nice patience that time, too. He let the blocker kind of set the corners for him. First and 10 now, ball just across midfield for the Lambkins. Give the ball to McGraw, drives upfield, steps out of one tackle, puts his shoulder in another defender, takes him downfield for a little ride, and gain a 9. Nice play.
Connor McGraw gets the call, puts up 9 yards for the Lambkins. Second down and 1 for Fort Collins.
Beautiful night here at French Field.
Teams are very similar as far as how many points they've scored and given up, and Greeley Central's given up a few more points.
Second and short now. Erickson back in the cut, looks downfield, scrambles around, can't find anybody. He has to move to his right. Being nice and patient now, just puts it down, steps upfield, spins away from a tackler. Nice spin move, gets him the first down, plus about 3 yards.
Cool customer, isn't he?
Yeah, that was just the way to do it. He just took his time out there, made the defender commit, and then just gave him a little spin move. Look a little Earl the Pearl going down the lane.
Greeley Central's averaging 21 points a game. Fort Collins, 23 a game. Of course, the big receiver for Fort Collins, Jake Leone. Got 38 receptions
already.
Yeah,
he got a lot of receptions. Not much thrown so far tonight. Another first down run there by the Lambkins. McGraw takes it for about 6 yards. Another quick update down in Cherry Creek. The defense picked off the ball and took it to the house for the Sabercats. They trail 21-7 now. That might give them that spark.
It's important they go down and represent. I know that.
Erickson rolls to his left.
Oh,
just a little too high, a little too much on it for Jackson Shore to hang on.
So after a lot of excitement to start the quarter off, now we're
Yeah.
Kind of locked into a
little back and forth.
Back and forth game.
Nice job by the guys up front. Andrew Van Norden, number 70. Number 78 is Quay McClaney. Also out there, we try to get all these linemen because they don't get the notoriety they should. Jonathan Engel, 53. Erickson looks, the old throwback underneath there. This time DeLang steps upfield out with a couple of arm tackles. But just if he gets the right route, the end zone, he's going to make it in easily. Yeah, right now Greeley Central is not putting a shoulder pad and they're just kind of reaching and grabbing. And just a great job that time, Corey Lang. I like the play design there because they faded right. He kind of hesitated, came back underneath. It's kind of a dangerous pass. You got to have your quarterback with a head on his shoulders like Erickson does, and that turned into an easy touchdown. Nice job. I mean, you got to compliment Lang. He just knew where to take the run. He wasn't going to go down with an arm tackle.
Well, Greeley Central has to watch out because Fort Collins has some playmakers, mm-hmm. You know, probably more than they've had in the past at some level.
PAT. Kick is up and good by Colby Shade. So 14-7 with 1:01 left here in the first quarter. Lambkins, after being down 7-0, scored two touchdowns. Back in control of the game. But if you've paid attention at all, you'll know that Greeley Central can strike pretty quickly too.
Hear the drum line there of the Fighting Regiment.
Mm-hmm. So the Lambkins will be kicking off.
Look at the pageantry there tonight, homecoming night here. 127 six-year-old Fort Collins High School.
Yeah, quite the run they've had here.
Insert smart comment about David Hoss's age right here.
Yep. Lambkins again faked that onside kick. You've got to honor it. Central was lined up and ready. They dispersed too. Shade, that's quite a leg. I mean, Jade's a freshman, too. He's driving the ball deep inside the five-yard line again. Chance to go outside, but good solid hit. Nice job of the Lambkins just keeping – you got a speed guy like that with Donovan Salazar. Just don't give him a chance to get a long run going, getting his stride lengthened out. Keep your lanes there. You know, you don't need to make the first hit, but if you know, he's not a big kid.
Don't you think he surprised the Lambkins on the first one? And
surprised
me. I think now they know.
Yeah, because he got around that corner and he dropped the hammer, and if it wasn't for the kicker just barely getting to his shoulder pads, it was an easy stroll. Because he had an extra gear that he left six or seven purple jerseys well in his wake. So, but good coverage that time. Kind of like you said, they're getting tuned to it. Ball inside the 15-yard line. That's going to be a back. It's going to have to step up in the pocket. It's going to get sacked.
Held the ball way too long.
All you got to do is look downfield. There's four receivers out in the formation, and everybody was blanketed. You know, man on man. Nice job by that secondary down there.
Well, I think quarterback has to make a decision quicker to go ahead and, you know, and run the ball at that point.
Yeah. Looking out there, safety, McKaylin Moore, along with number 25, Jake Leone. And Colby Shade out there too, 26. And number four in the near side corner is Shea Wind, and they all just did a nice job downfield coverage. Escamilla is back in his end zone, throws a screen pass, and he's going to be tackled for another loss. This Wildcats just keep going backwards.
And 65.
You're going to throw just another pass or two like that, and you're going to give up the safety. That was Jack Pedersen. Just good headhunting there, wasn't it?
Yes.
And that's the end of the first quarter here at French Field. Lambkins have come back after being down 7 to score two unanswered touchdowns and have the Wildcats on their heels. 14-7 they lead. You're watching Stream It Sports.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
You're watching PSD High School Sports live in high definition on Stream It Sports NoCo.
So we're back here, homecoming night. Beautiful Fort Collins, Colorado, Fort Collins High School. Just had all the alumni stand.
Yeah, and I told everybody this. There's quite a number in the crowd here.
Some of them have been coming to the games ever since
they
graduated and decided to stay here. And so you saw the Greeley Central huddle there. So we'll see what they've got up their sleeve for 3rd and 21.
Yeah, here's that. That's not the play you generally dial up. I mean, every play is supposed to go the distance, but that's usually without the other 11 out there. So they've got to get it out past the 24-yard line. This could be as in his end zone. Takes the snap right away, just heads up field, trying to get some room. And actually, that wasn't even Escamilla back there. That was a direct snap to
15.
Yeah, actually, well, no, it was. He still was in there. I thought they substituted him out, so he did take that. And but I think that's just a good heads-up play. You got your punter from out of the end zone and gain yourself about 15 yards of breathing room.
Well, I'll tell you what, if he makes a juke move on the he had a first down.
Yeah.
He kind of decided just to
fourth and six.
Kind of just try to run over him, but Rudy, they call him, Escamilla.
Yep. Another rugby-style punt here coming from the Wildcats, and that took a huge bounce. Look at that roll. He got 15 yards of roll there. It goes out of bounds. So he kicked the ball from the 19-yard line. It's going to go out at about the 36 on the other end. And there's the one that advantage of the rugby-style punt. You can take your time, and there's no rush. I think we're going to start seeing some pressure coming from that left side of the Lambkins defense. They're going to need to get upfield there to just stop that delay. Put some kind of pressure on. So first and 10 now after the fourth down punt by the Wildcats. Lambkins take over on their own 36. Erickson in the pistol. Give the ball off the inside there. Handoff still going downfield. Gross just moves across infield. Nobody's getting a hand on him. Great job up front by the Lambkins. I'd like to talk about those old linemen again. I didn't get a couple of them called out, but Tanner Orth there, number 59 and 56. Also along there is Kyle Schulman, another captain. That was a wall they built that time, didn't they?
First down for Collins.
Our favorite announcer in the city here. A lot more fun. Erickson, nice job just juking, stepping up field, running away from tacklers out in the open field. He's going to run away from everybody.
What an impressive looking athlete he is.
Yeah, there's the most fortunate transfer in a few years and moving in. But he had two men floating on the option out there, and when the defender doesn't show you their numbers, you just stuck that left foot into the turf and turned up field and just went running. So about a 40-yard plus run puts the Lambkins up convincingly now, 20-7 PAT pending. Yeah, I think he's going to block that one. What do you think?
Yeah, I think he might have an opportunity.
A little jumped offside that time by the right rush in for the Wildcats. And it's like one of those, well, if I'm here, I might as well take care of it.
Make it really,
because otherwise it's just a waste of time. I think he blocked it with his knee.
I'll tell you what, Erickson has some quick feet, doesn't he?
Yeah, that was he made a couple side cuts there and then just turned on the afterburners.
Or if he plays any other sports.
And the extra point is up and good at the foot of Colby Shade.
It's Colby Shade, the freshman. Very strong leg. Kicking off. Three PATs so here tonight. Been playing a defensive back.
See the Lambkins coming off the field. And
yeah, just a good, well-put-together drive after the taking the ball right down the field.
Well, they've got that look like they've had in the past, that, you know, they played that tough preseason, pre-conference schedule, and only got beat by four, I believe, to Loveland. And Loveland's been rolling over everybody.
Yeah. And if you hear us in Loveland, we'd love to talk about your games, too.
Yeah.
Streaming Sports, we have games up and down the Front Range. You go to streamingsports.com. You can find games from the South Metro area all the way up here in Northern Colorado. You can find us at streamingsports.com/PSD or Stream It Sports NoCo on Twitter. David Haase along with Randy McCoy and Abby Block camera tonight. What a gorgeous night here at French Field. No wind at all. Cool out, but not really cold. Shade drives the ball, hooking it towards the left corner of the field and goes into the end zone for the touchback.
That's a great kick. I mean, it's as good as you can do it.
Yeah. Well, they list him here as a freshman. That's I'm pretty impressed on the unless I got a mistake on my my sheet, but I don't think so. Yeah. That's not going to be my hardest name to pronounce tonight, and we're going to go with what we see on a couple of them if they come up and make a play. But one of our challenges every year is some kids with really unique names. Butchered more than a few of them. Give over the left side out of the Greeley Central. That's about the first time they've been under center that time.
Well, the thing Greeley Central has to watch out now is they cannot turn the ball over.
Well, or you can't go three and out in less than 5 seconds.
Yeah, you can't.
We're talking to one of their coaches before the game, and you know, and they are a very pass-oriented team, and you know, that's one of the problems. All of a sudden, if you go three and out, you only run off 20 seconds. Your defense is back out there, and that's just it, that's not a strong winning formula. You've seen with teams that just throw the ball all the time. You know, it's a very feast or famine way to play.
Even at their very best with Fairview.
Yes.
You know, yep. I mean, they had Division I players, but.
Escamilla throws a quick out taken on the by the inside slot receiver, and he had to get rid of that too. He had Purple breathing down on his neck. Nice throw though, and a catch on the outside. Cervantes out there on the catch, number 17, wrapped up pretty well, so brings up about third and four. Been a little while since the first down accomplished by Central Wildcats. They trail 21-7 with 9:20 left here in the second quarter. So no backs. Trips receiver here near the wide side of the field. And now we just had a flag thrown, so I'm thinking we're going to have somebody that lined up and then moved away. Actually, it's going to be encroachment. Some from Collins lined up off sides and took a stance. Ball hadn't even been snapped yet. So the result of the penalty is a first down for the Wildcats, first and 10 now. Ball beyond the 31-yard line. Lambkins are still pretty much staying in a man, a little cover two over the top. It's still man underneath. The slot receiver's uncovered. Escamilla, this is just a straight rollout run. Never even looked to throw the ball. Trying to just spread the field and use his athleticism, but a nice tackle downfield by Jace Whitey. So no gain.
Erickson's thrown for, coming into the game, 1,082 yards. He's also rushed for almost 300 yards, and he's gone over 300 with that run.
Oh, yeah. And a couple of others earlier there, too. Escamilla back to throw, tries to look downfield, hits his inside man.
Nice pass.
Does throw a nice ball. That time, hits it. Quick throw to Salazar.
Jake Leone has six receiving touchdowns.
Tell you what, I mean, you've got to be in condition. You're going to play this game, especially where these two teams play. A lot of wide outs, a lot of spread offense here. No back again for the Wildcats. Lambkins show blitz. They bring it. They got more coming they can block. Escamillo, nice job of getting out of his hands. A great effort in the open field by that receiver. He turned around.
They got the first down.
Nice camel work that time there, too. Abby getting right in and tight on that. What a play. And just across the mark of the chains.
And that's Brett Yackey on the...
Nice catch, Yackey.
6'1", 167-pound junior.
Yeah, that was a great effort. Quick flare out, get the ball out of his hands nicely that time. What a great job that time. Good play recognition out there. But, you know, just the way to get it out of his hands... to make sure that he had a chance for Cervantes to make a catch and run. I need to make a clarification earlier. I had the wrong player out there on the field on defense. I attributed Mr. Leone also playing secondary, which I know is not his position. That's why it made me think. But Cameron Terman, number 28, has made a couple plays. I want to make sure I get that right. So second down and 10 after the incompletion, just a catch and a toss right. That play just doesn't have a chance. I don't know how the quarterback's leaning right, moving right, tossing right. You know, it's
how can something be so right, be so wrong?
Yeah, that's right. Break in the song here. Name that artist. If you can tweet that artist out, you've got a Schrader's gift card coming to you. Tweet that out to Stream It Sports NoCo. Brings up 3rd and 12. Pressure coming again. Escamilla stands and fires down the middle. Just about pulled in. Nice effort, though, going across the middle where he was in no man's land, too. That was a great effort. Once again, number 11 stretched out for it. Bonham just didn't bring it in. So forcing another punt. Nice job by the Lambkins. And they've got consistent pressure. He can't sit back there and get comfortable, can he?
No, he can't, because if he looks like the kind that could pick you apart
Nice job coming at Jack Pedersen among the others guys, and then interior just a concert effort. Still no rush by the Lambkins, so they're giving plenty of time on that rugby kick. He just pushes it downfield. Unfortunately, again, trying to get when there's no pressure whatsoever. It does need to be a hurry, but all of a sudden he just has to kick it out.
He was close enough there, man. I'd have taken a look at the.
I'm sure he was
running around.
Well, they had four defenders all standing there. You know, they're placing play and contain. They're not even trying to rush.
See the bench there for Greeley Central.
Yeah, a couple guys back there moving around, but, you know, they've got about 50, 60 fans made it over. Welcome to those who stayed home and watch us. Thanks for catching us on Stream It Sports. Erickson under center, spins out, looks downfield, trying to do a throwback. He's got a man open, lays it up over the top.
Oh my gosh.
A little too much on it. He had Jackson Shore, long developing play, but he put it out there just a little beyond his grasp.
I'll tell you what, man, he throws a pretty ball, doesn't he?
You know, it's easy to go with it because he's a lefty, but that ball never wobbles. He's got that Ken Stabler kind of finish on it. That just is like a laser, just a lance, a nice tight spiral. You know, as coaches say, he can spin it. Trips here to the near side of the field.
He's got great field vision, too. Been very impressed with him.
That one was a little too slow developing. He kind of stared around and that time tried to get it out to Leone and just wasn't time to make that play work. And actually, I think Leone needed to step towards the play itself. And that was part of the disconnect.
He might have thrown it in the ground on purpose because he saw the pressure. Yeah, because I'll tell you what, he gets that too high. That could have been a pick six.
Yeah, you walk into those. Well, and that's what you see now. I was looking out here. Greeley West has got to get somebody. Their slot receiver's got no man over the top of him. Ball run up the middle on third down
I'll
there.
I'll tell you what, man, you could have run a slant right there. And
well, yeah.
He'd still be running.
Yeah.
You could have changed the play at the
safety is 18 yards deep and the defensive back, outside linebacker, strong safety, whatever you want to call him, walked out to be five, and he was 5 and 5 from him. I'm sure that will be spotted because that was just a seam pattern. All you got to do is just lay it over the top real quick and get it before the safety drops in there.
Somebody's got to see that.
So, fourth down punt coming. Ball goes straight up in the air to the left. Bouncing around about on the 40.
And right about where they had the ball when they ended. Mm-hmm. So let's just pretend like that 2 minutes didn't happen,
and
huh?
4:50 left here in the half, 21-7 Lambkins. A lot of pace early. Now I think that I've said before, the kind of the air's gone out of the balloon. Both teams are kind of waiting back and stopping the longer play. Kind of settled down, and you know the counterpunching has started. Chance though now for the Wildcats to answer to get a score before half.
That's a great
push up the middle.
Run.
Yeah, nice job up there. I just looking at part of the reason that honoring just the speed, I was noticing both the safeties for Collins are at 14 to 15 yards deep. I mean, really deep. And that's just a testament to the speed that they've got on the outside with Cervantes and Bonham over there with for Greeley Central. Beautiful night for football, though. Here earlier tonight, we had a victory by Poudre. Broke out to a big lead and had to kind of hold on, but ended up beating Fountain Fort Carson in their first conference game. Last night, Eagle Crest came up and really showed why we're one of the top teams in the state and put it to Rocky Mountain 42-7.
What a stiff arm there.
Yeah, it really was. And just about a chance to go out and around was Bonham again.
He's got that look like he could break one if...
Between Bonham and Cervantes there, there's a chance to go. And also... number 88 hasn't had a pass. I think that's part of the reason there, but Donovan Salazar, that's three guys with some pretty serious wheels. First and 10 now, ball in the 40, plenty of time, 4:02 left in the half. Four down linemen still for the Lambkins. A little delay draw there and just stumbled, tackled by the turf monster. Number 32 for the Wildcats is Brett Yackey. Just couldn't get started, could he?
No, and you know, you saw how much room they were giving number 88 up at the top.
Mm-hmm.
They were giving him a full 10 yards.
Yeah, and Escamilla, there's a strong enough arm there. Yeah, that's gonna be one of those step hard and step right back and just put it in his hands. And if you got a 5 yard, you know, a 2 step cushion. That's a bunch.
Now he's up on him this time.
Yeah, he's got the little cover six, the safety over the top on the seam. Trips to the top of your screen. Escamilla was looking. Basically, they're running underneath. He's got a chance, throws it just in time before he crosses the line. It looks like the catch was made the 30-yard line. Nice throw, great catch. Caught by number 17 down there, Cervantes. Actually, it might have been Salvador. No, it wasn't 88. Okay. Salazar on the catch.
You know, it's funny because he hasn't really thrown deep yet. I mean, everything's been intermediate.
Yeah.
Tremendous accuracy, though.
Yeah, you got to take what they're giving you. You're seeing a lot of two safety look. This time they're up. They got an extra lineman coming in. A little crossbuck in the backfield that time. Trying to get those linebackers a step, and they brought that backside, the right side tackle came over and did a kickout block. You know, crossbuck play is, that's as old school as it gets. The first back standing on the left side of the quarterback goes in front of him. He fakes the handoff to him. Then the right back takes a counter step outside, then turns around and comes right back underneath. And if you just get that little seam, you know, get somebody to just step out of their seam there, all of a sudden you've got a ton of room. And, it's off to the races.
It's going to be a timeout.
So timeout here at the field, 2:33 left in the half, 21-7, Lambkins lead. You're watching Stream It Sports.
Wherever it is you want to go, all you need to see is the next 200 feet. That's how life unfolds. A leap of faith. Even if you can't see it, your destination is out there. So just keep going, and you'll get there, 200 feet at a time. The Corolla. Toyota. Let's go places.
back in here now. You see the huddle on the sideline there. Coach Rice out with his defense. Don't want to give up one before half. Two touchdown lead going in, as we talked about that. You know, that was kind of a springboard from the first game today when the Trojans from Fountain Fort Carson got that field goal right before half, and they exploded in that second half. That's going to be under center, fakes back to both backs, down sideline, single coverage out there. Salazar all by himself, leans forward. What a great heads-up play. Knew where to place the ball, didn't he?
Boy, again, very, very impressive passer for sure, and really athlete overall. I mean, he's run pretty decent half running the ball as well. And he's kind of taking what they're giving him, you know.
No, that's a great point. They're really, you said they've really not tried to stretch it and take it downfield. I mean, they're given a cushion. They just know the speed that's across from them there. I mean, I look for Greeley Central to have a pretty good 4x1 relay team if those kids all run this spring. So first and 10, ball inside the 20-yard line. This can be a back to throw, steps up in the pocket, takes his time, has to spin out. He's got a lot of room in front of him. Tucks it away, outruns one defender, still going, just tripped up.
Boy.
He had one move to make before he'd have been in the end zone.
Well, his momentum would have taken him in the end zone if he could have.
Yeah, if he'd have just stepped up. Because he only had one defender there, and that would have been a really tough open field tackle to make. That was a great effort, though. Michael Field did run him down. Just got that, just hooked his heel, didn't he?
He did, and as you see the quarterback walking over, getting the play.
I just hate that. I can't say how much I hate that. We just saw it the last game. How much time did Fountain Fort Carson waste when they needed to be on the field running plays? They had two plays. It took them 20 seconds to get the play call to the line and get it run. I'll get off my soapbox for a moment.
Okay.
Now we've got a stoppage in play for a official timeout to actually do a measure. When you look out there, I mean, Greeley Central's got some size up front. Not as much of it as Collins has, but
first down.
They got some. So first down now marked off inside the 10-yard line, actually inside the near the 8. This is a big stop that the Lambkins would love to get here right before half. First and 10, or first and goal to go, 2:13 left, plenty of time. And this is where I think Escamilla's feet are just about as dangerous as his arm.
Oh, yeah.
Twins both side now, back set to his right.
I mean, he's run for 10 yards about every time.
Just, oh,
my gosh.
He threw a pick. Yeah, his receiver, he had the receiver running the slant, and the receiver did the out. He came in and turned out, and he just fired it in there. And number one, McCalen Moore just sat on the play. He saw the ball coming, and the receiver would have been between him and the ball. And what a break for the Lambkins, and what a heads-up play by Moore.
And, you know, that's the kind of play, too, that he pumps once, and his receiver standing by himself in the end zone, too.
Yeah. He committed to it. Like I said, the slant, and Moore crowded the slant, and maybe the receiver thought, if I get picked on the inside, I just step back out and go. Minute 59 left.
Obviously, they weren't on the same page, and that's the kind of things that happen to an 0-5 team sometimes.
That's a very good point. With 1:59 left. Lampkins just run the ball out of the I formation, really gained nothing. Ball goes forward for about a yard.
Impressive clock, drive by Greeley
still
Central.
Running. Yeah, I thought Greeley Central might take the timeout right there.
No gain on that running play. Brings up second down.
Clock still running down to minute that. No, they did take the timeout. They let about 12 seconds go. I thought they'd have done that right away to stop it. But a minute 39 left here in the half. 21-7, Fort Collins has got the ball back.
Who wants more peas?
Go away.
Oh, Daddy hates pop-up ads.
Go away.
Hashtag dinner time.
Scroll forward.
Choose selfie.
No.
Selfie.
Scroll forward.
Delete selfie.
Go away. Bookmark.
No.
Go away.
No, post photo.
Scroll up. Scroll forward.
Hashtag gravy.
Faster.
Go faster. The First Bank mobile app. Technology has never been so easy.
So we're back here now. Second and 10, minute 39 left before half. Fossil Ridge is down at Cherry Creek getting showed a few things.
Yeah, 35-7 at halftime there. They trail. Their only score came on a defensive pick six. Lambkins content to just to push it up the middle. But I tell you what, though, that was second down. Now, we had some fuzzy math in the first game. I did talk to one of the officials afterwards, and they had about a three-second differential. I don't think that Fountain Fort Carson cared. There was enough time on it, but okay, we must have the wrong number on the scoreboard because it showed zero before they did. They had another timeout taken there. So we'll be back after one more message.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
Won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
See the Purple Regiment band getting ready to
head out in the field.
Yes.
Well, after the, we're trying to do an account up here. We've got some numbers configured here, but that timeout was allowed. Minute 26 left here. Lambkins still got third down in their end zone. Erickson fakes it, runs the outside. He might get first down yardage here. He's going to be taken down just short. Clock is still running.
He called his own number there.
Mm-hmm. Popular opinion. The 21-7 Lambkins lead. They'd love to just be able to run this out. It's fourth down. They've got to run another play. It's kind of one of those moments where you're going to, I would almost actually see the Lambkins let the clock run down. If they're going to punt it, but they're going to call timeout as soon as the back judge makes his second. There he goes. He did. He made his call. So a timeout's going to be taken here by the Lambkins. And basically what you want to do is, okay, we're going to be getting punt formation, and we're going to have to give it back to them. They're going to have time. And they're going to have to punt the ball. Punter's going to kick it inside the 10-yard line, maybe inside the 5 even, depending on how many steps he gets away with. But they're going to get the ball with pretty good field position and plenty of time. There'll be at least 25 seconds left after that play unless there's a long run. And it'll be on that side of the field.
So we'll be back after station ID here to see what happens.
You're watching PSD High School Sports live in high definition on Stream It Sports NoCo.
Coach Rice talking to him about their options.
Quickly there, I said, okay, you can't let anybody buy you. You got to be a high...
Yeah,
you know, protect block, and they've got a couple. They'll have a couple gunners outside just to keep you honest. But actually, Erickson's back there to punt.
Best thing that could happen for Greeley Central is a block.
Erickson gets it, no pressure. Ball kicked off side of his foot, bounces around the 40, takes a central bounce, takes another central bounce. So they're going to get the ball with 29 seconds left on the 34-yard line of the Lambkins. So nice job by the Central defense.
If you're Central, you got to feel pretty good. You just ran the ball down. Got within... should have scored, really.
Yeah, that was just one of those misread plays and happens, but Moore, you know, made the great read and jumped the route and they got the pick, saved the touchdown, and if they can hold him out here, he's going to make still keep it a two-score game going into half.
See if they go over top now.
Escamilla back here is going to roll to his right. Fires it out just a little too tall that time. Had his man out there in the flat going again, too. I like the call. Cervantes is out there, and he catches it. If he turns upfield, fine. If not, go out of bounds, stop the clock. 5 seconds off the clock there, 24 seconds left.
With
So second and 10 now after the incompletion. That's going to be, he's looking downfield. He's going to get pushes right. He's going to have to just throw the ball away. It's going to get back to the line of scrimmage. That was a very good athletic effort just to do that, because he had big O number 56 all up in his kitchen there. And Kyle Schulman, the captain, just a great effort going around the outside. Kyle, or, and then Corey Lang, too, from behind, just doing to chase him down.
Well, he doesn't have time, really, to throw it downfield.
No, you're right.
I mean, he's, when he rolls out, he gives himself some time, but.
So 17 seconds left, third down. They got time for the two more plays. Screen play coming up the middle. They're underthrown, too. Boy, if he'd have got that downfield, there was a lot of room. Nice diving play there. Garrett McGraw did kind of get underneath that one, but the ball was just underthrown. McGraw was coming from the outside trying to get in into the play lane, but didn't. So that'll bring up fourth down. Now you make the decision. Do you, if you get an incompletion here, do you want to give the Lambkins a down, or do you just run it and take it away? I think if you're on this side of the field, you gotta try, don't you?
Yeah, I think you gotta throw it up in the end zone, especially with the speed he's got and the athletes.
Well,
out
yeah,
there.
And you're 0-5.
Yeah,
you gotta make a chance. Yeah.
Triples over there, whatever you call it.
Yeah, a little bunch formation right on the sideline. Someone's going to have to make a run to the middle. He's going to have time to throw it. That's the thing, and he doesn't. So the sack is going to be made with 7 seconds left in the half. Pretty quick whistle there. That'll be a change of down. So you're definitely going to get a chance for a final play.
Well, and we've seen Erickson throw deep.
Yeah.
I think as one of the games you missed, but he threw a
he's got
beautiful
the arm.
Long pass.
And a lot of times, you see it a few times, and when it's executed, it's a thing of beauty. But the hook and ladder is one of those plays that, right now he's going to have to throw the ball from his 35-yard line or so. And if you have a chance, looks like Lambkins are trying to find another body. They're missing a guard. Take somebody, anybody that put their hand on the ground. Erickson goes back, no backs, trying to look straight downfield. He's got room, plenty of time, not much of a rush. Nice job by the play. And he's got stepped out of bounds. Wow. I could have sworn he stepped out of bounds at least once there. I was looking at a tug of war going on with one of the offensive linemen.
Well, what happened is he ran, and then all of his receivers were too far down the field to even throw it to him. So that's the last play of the half. With our score 21-7, Fort Collins over Greeley Central. We'll be back with the second half after these messages.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Great news! We broke our all-time sales record, and it's all thanks to my nephew, Skyler.
Bro, it's Sky.
After my brother made me hire Sky, I switched us to First Bank to make up for him. Now business is better than ever.
No matter the reason, switching to First Bank can help your business grow.
Wayne? Everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country Store car washes, just shiny clean.
You may take the field in performance. Washington! To present our 2016 Fort Collins High School Royalty Court. Issues have been nominated by the class group and have proven to be an incredible group. Nominees for this year's Count and Countess of the freshman class are Katie Dern, dancer and bilingual. Sam Tolson enjoys being the youngest and favorite twin and created a holiday about cinnamon rolls. Tegan Janison loves dogs and has been dating Roland for over a year. Roland Thompson loves grilled cheese sandwiches and has been dating Tegan for over a year. Allie Beckner enjoys swimming and plays cello. And Ben Tolson plays the trombone and likes being the older twin. Your 2016 Countess is Miss Tegan Janison. Your 2016 count is Sam Tolleson. Congratulations. Next up, the nominees for this year's Duke and Duchess of the sophomore class are Miss Paige Ellis. She enjoys long car rides and has broken her foot 6 times. Her escort is Johnny Ibarra. He enjoys skateboarding and misses his long hair. Next up, Sana Westenberg plays soccer and speaks Dutch. Patrick Faust, his first name starts with a P and his last name starts with an F. Next up is Isabel Lane. She enjoys running and playing baseball. Her escort is Rolly Carney. He's Jewish and celebrates Hanukkah. Your 2016 Duchess is Miss Paige Elliott. Your 2016 Duke, Mr. Rowey Carney. Congratulations. Next up, the nominees for junior class Prince and Princess are Miss Alyssa Gallegos. She can sing and enjoys the beach. Her escort is Mr. Keith Pixler. He plays rugby and is an athletic trainer. Next up is Jordan Ostroso. She has a fraternal twin and likes hiking our beautiful horse too. Her escort is Mr. Shea Wynn. He likes throwing his chest there and kissing babies. Next up, Miss Bella Cruz. She wants to be a filmmaker and considers herself funny. Her escort is Mr. Jacob Leon. He plays football and awkwardly has a gnarly happy trail. Your 2016 princess, Miss Bella Cruz. And your 2016 prince, Mr. Keith Pickler.
At this time, we'd like to recognize this year's 2016 Fort Collins High School Senior Royalty Court. Our first couple is Mr. Eli McCoy and Miss Ava Shutter. Eli is the son of Tori and Jen McCoy. He's involved in football, peer counseling, student council, National Honor Society, National Science Honor Society. Eli is a three-year academic letter winner, three-year varsity football letter, and a one-year wrestling letter. After school, Eli plans to go to college and be an orthopedic surgeon. Ava is the daughter of Gary and Denise Shooter. She's involved in art and has a letter in academics at Fort Collins High School. After high school, she would like to become a pediatric or trauma room nurse. Next up, our second couple is Mr. Ben Fraley and Miss Maddie McCambridge. Maddie's the daughter of Marin and Adam McCambridge. She coaches volleyball at Preston Middle School and is our student body secretary. Maddie lettered in volleyball at FCHS for 3 years in a row. After graduation, Maddie hopes to attend Kansas State University as well as do mission work in other countries. Ben is the son of Kayleen and Don Fraley. Ben is our student body president. He's involved in the peers and cross country and enjoys skiing. Ben is a four-year academic letter winner at Fort Collins High School. After high school, he would like to attend a four-year university, study business with a minor in economics and political science. Our third couple is Kaylee Shaw and Jake Sinek. Kaylee's the daughter of Kim and Casey Shaw. Kaylee's involved in soccer, skiing, fishing, athletic training, volunteering with special needs preschoolers. She's earned letters in music, academics, and soccer at Fort Collins High School. After school, Kaylee would like to go on to medical school to become a doctor. Jake is the son of Karen and William Sinek. Jake is a member of Tower Theater and has been the team officer for 2 years. Jake has received the Gypsy Rose for outstanding dedication and hard work in the theater. After high school, Jake plans to graduate from a top theater program, as well as have a successful theater and eventually start his own company. Our final senior couple is Jazz Ross and Joe Spence. Jazz is the daughter of Melissa Cody. She's involved in choir and cheer at FCHS. She won Best All-Around Student in kindergarten. After high school, she will attend Fort Lewis and study environmental science. Joe is the son of Dave and Lisa Spence. He's involved in lacrosse and the tie flying club. He's a three-year letter winner in lacrosse. After high school, he plans on attending a four-year college and to pursue a career in fisheries biology. Give them a hand, folks. All right, ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 homecoming queen is Miss Jazz Ross. Your 2016 homecoming king, Mr. Ben Fraley. Give all the royalty a hand and our purple regiment too. Thank you.
Honestly, the experience here at Pedersen sold me. Quick, easy.
It was easy.
An easy process.
Super easy.
It's just as easy as could be. My name is Sonny Lubick, and I've been a customer of Pedersen's for over 25 years. After a while, you're not a customer anymore, you're family. They really build up a relationship. And I think probably the thing that keeps me coming back the most is their service is easy. It's too easy, in fact.
Great news! We broke our all-time sales record, and it's all thanks to my nephew, Skyler.
Bro, it's Sky.
After my brother made me hire Sky, I switched us to First Bank to make up for him. Now business is better than ever.
No matter the reason, switching to First Bank can help your business grow.
Wayne, everyone knows by now that Schrader's Country Stores have the best car washes around. They don't need to see you standing in the car wash explaining the undercarriage wash, the rocker panel spray, the protective finish application, and the jet dryer. No, Wayne, all you have to do is see the beautiful shine on my nice clean car. No muss, no fuss, and I'm certainly not all wet.
You won't get soaked at Schrader Country's.
And welcome back, folks. Second half, Fort Collins Lambkins 21, the Greeley Central Wildcats 7. And
good stop there at the end of the half for the Lambkins. Get the pick at the goal line. And, you know, defensively, a lot up and down the field, a lot of it on special teams there for Greeley Central. They had 100 yards, 103 yards passing, negative yards rushing, several sacks, great pressure up front by the Lambkin D. They'll get the ball to start the second half. Single deep receiver. Looks like Corey Lang back there. We got a little harder to see this time of night with it getting a little dark down there. Squib kick going to bounce around. Be taken. It's going to actually get by him. Goes into the end zone, so no chance for return there. Actually, it's Michael Cadlick. Footballs take funny bounces.
You never can tell where that old football is going to bounce.
Mm-hmm. So beautiful night here. Thanks for tuning in to Stream It Sports. StreamItSports.com/PSD. David Haase along with Randy McCoy, Abby Block on camera tonight doing a great job. Homecoming night here. Saw the band, the royalty announcements, everything for the Lambkins at halftime. Great time to be in high school. It takes everybody back, doesn't it? First snap, jet sweep goes outside to McGraw, turns up. Kind of. Ball pops out at the end. He was down, but...
But we've noticed that doesn't seem to make a difference on some.
Oh, yeah, there's... Yeah. Wait till I see the whistle before I call it, because it's... I've stepped in it a couple times. Gained about three. Quickly back up on the ball. Lampkin's trying to get a little pace coming out here. I like that. Erickson fires it out in the bubble screen outside. Getting upfield. I don't know if that's Leone out there. Trying to get him in the game.
It's his first reception, if
yeah.
It is.
Yeah. And Leone, in the first half, I could say he had the one the short term. That time, Erickson turned and stepped into the throw and really put some pace on it. Boy, Greeley Central gambled on the run that time. They brought the house. And McGraw just gets tripped up. If not... I think he would have had just a foot race. Sometimes you play the run on the way to the quarterback, and that's kind of what they did there. They just dropped everybody in. Sideline check, trips this side, single receiver up at the top. Erickson fakes, got a man right down the middle, slips it to him. Wow. It's going to be a foot race for the end zone. Ball thrown from the 35 for a 65-yard touchdown. Nice throw, but an even better catch made by number 15, Jackson Shore. Ball's a little behind him, grabbed it with his fingertips, did a 360, didn't he, and he just took it on in. What a great athletic play.
Great hands.
And when we talked about that earlier, that seam route running right down the hash, it was right there, and nice job by the coaching staff and a great read, throw, catch, and run by the Lambkins to start off the scoring here in the second half. PAT coming now. Good snap, good hold, kick is up. I'll tell you what, we've always talked about it, but Colby Shea being a freshman shows a lot of promise as a kicker already. And we have so many here in town over the years, and one of the very best obviously came out of Collins several years back. Welch goes to Wisconsin. I think he's still one of their top scorers.
Got a good crop of kickers this year, really.
Oh, yeah. No,
Bergeson.
Bergeson over there. Paducah's had some long ones for Rocky. And obviously Shade here. And then Austin Davis continuing the family tradition at Poudre. So a lightning bolt right down the middle of the field. Lambkins go up, and that kind of might, you know, that could take the air right out of you if you're the Wildcats. We'll see how they react to it. I mean, the game really started quickly, great pace, both back and forth. You know, the first, you know, score quickly by Greeley, then two touchdown answer by Fort Collins, and they went off. And then the kind of just to be termed a push-pull contest. You were really thinking they were going to onside that one, didn't you? I had a thought.
they sold it pretty well.
Yeah. Well, and we've seen it so often, too. A lot of rotation. That kick's going to come short of the 10-yard line. Breaks to the outside. Is going to be tackled. Nice job. Once again, Lambkins after that first and open kickoff. That number 88 just barely got stopped Salazar. And
Siegfried on the stop. Great stop.
Yeah, Colin it really Siegfried. Was. They've done a nice job down there open field. They kept inside the 25. Ball in the 23. I mean, one thing with as the kick's in the air, but you know, you say Shade's done it, the hang time is still pretty good, too. So the double back formation in the shotgun again. Gives the second back coming through. Big hole on the right side. Turns up field. First down yardage. Just tripped up. That almost turned into a foot race.
Yes, it did. And Mr. Yancey had visions of six,
Yackey.
Didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Yackey?
Brett Yackey on the
oh,
run
sorry,
there.
Oh, sorry. Yancey. Yackey.
Yeah. Call me what you want. Just give me the ball.
My apologies to the Yancey and Yackey families.
Yes, we covered them all. Escamilla, though, and we've seen, you know, the athleticism and the wideouts they've got. They, if you see, if they try to find that one big tight end, they don't really have that as part of their offense. Escamilla quickly gets it out of his hands, but a great read on the play out there. Number two, Cadillac, the captain, showing why he's out there in that open, makes a solid tackle. So second 11 now after the tackle for loss by Cadillac there on the quick flare pass. Single back trips near side, wide side of field, single receiver on the top. We have pump fakes trying to look downfield. He now is just is in life preservation mode. He knew he was had nowhere to go, did he?
Well, we haven't seen him kick deep or throw deep because he doesn't have time to throw deep.
Yeah. Well, one thing I have noticed, too, I have not seen the long drag route, nothing really coming short across the middle with all these speed guys trying to bring someone deep there because all four receivers that time were downfield 20 yards plus. That's just a tough way for a quarterback when he's got no one to bail out to as a ball, to deliver the ball to.
Down to 45 degrees now.
Getting
started today at 64. crystal clear, though. It's just.
Yeah, beautiful night.
As long as you got a little jacket.
Corey Lang chasing Escamilla. He throws it downfield. It's going to be a pick. If it's in on the field, it is. That ball is just thrown up for grabs.
Yeah, that was a frustration. I think that was a frustration interception.
Yeah, it really was. Shea Wind was just waiting for it there. And he did a great job knowing there had to be a receiver in the area. But he got underneath it. Defensive backs, you've got to go get the ball at the highest point. Even if you think you're the only one in the area, you still get off the ground. He went up and got it and secured it. So here's a chance for the Lambkins to put the dagger in here. They would lead 28-7. They get back-to-back scores here. And I think it's time to try to work on your stats as a defensive sack leader. Ball behind there. McGraw does a nice job following his lineman. Bowls over a couple defenders. Another line of the strong, you know, short but explosive running backs that Collins has, you know, Schroyer and others over the years. And we talk about the combinations of quarterbacks and running backs. You know, Kyler Sigsby and Schroyer were a pair a couple years ago. And right now, Erickson and McGraw are the latest addition. Second and short. Erickson rolls out. Is being pursued from behind. Knows he's got to get rid of it. He's got a man wide up and downfield once again. Easy pitch and catch. Still a little bit behind him, though. And Jackson short. That's the second catch he's made. Ball behind him, spinning around. Just showing great athleticism.
Well, somebody needs to guard him. somebody needs to cover him.
You might want to find him and stay with him because he was 5 yards behind his receiver. So,
and he's not even their main receiver. So
tonight he's a prime. Trips here to the near side of the field. First and 10, actually first and goal, ball on the 8-yard line. Nobody on the far side over there, and it's going to be an easy touchdown. What a great read by Erickson. The defensive back was playing almost in the end zone. And he had Antonio Burgos out there. And Randy, I mean, that was just a mistake on the defensive alignment there because the young man was in the end zone, defending the end zone, as coaches like to say, is it doesn't make sense. You know, you're not in the right spot. So a quick score there after one score, chance to go up by 4 touchdowns now with the PAT pending. But Erickson did a great job of just seeing that read over there quickly, just got it out of his hands. Low snap, gets on the tee. Nice hands. Erickson did a great job of taking the one hopper, putting it up on the tee, and Shade knocks it through. So after just a little time expiring here in the third quarter, 2 quick touchdowns to the Lambkins. They lead 35-7.
You're watching PSD High School Sports live in high definition on Stream It Sports NoCo. I
want to thank our banner sponsor, GoJo Sports. GoJo Sports has been providing team sporting needs since 1974. Screen printing, embroidery, letter jackets, and more. Your local place to get high school gear. Check out their new location at 1437 Riverside, just down from the Coloradoan. On the south side of the street. Let our sponsors know how much you appreciate them helping us here bring you this live high school football game. Schrader Oil, Pedersen Toyota and Volvo, and First Bank.
So like our start of our first half, we've had a real quick pace. Unfortunately for the Central Wildcats, they didn't score. 2 quick touchdowns again by the Lambkins.
Well, and if you're Greeley Central now, you've really got to watch out.
Yeah,
you get 2 more touchdowns, you've getting mercy ruled here. So Greeley Central really needs to, you know, hold on to the ball. And that's not what they do typically because they pass all the time.
Yeah, no, they're very, you know, the old run and fun gun. And still, you have to put points on the board. Squib kick this time, bouncing downfield. Still gets down to Salazar, tips it around. One stiff arm, nice job, cuts up field. Another stiff arm is going to be corralled out near the 30-yard line. I like the idea, though, that you don't give a chance to get the speed up because the speed guys want to make a hard cut and see if you adjust. And
He was feeling it there. He got up to about half speed, but.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Jose Estrada.
7:02 left here in the third quarter.
I don't see our buddy Big E down there. Do you?
Well, I think he might be sitting this one out. I think they're a softball today. Collins said, oh.
Boy.
Defensive back thought he'd go for the pick there. Nice catch. That was a long throw. Very long throw. Gained about 7 yards. Cervantes made a nice catch there, but as you look at it, Colby Shade tried to cut in front there at the same time, too. So second and long four. This can be a back to throw. Steps up, can't find anybody. Now he brings his eyes down. Gets away from a couple there. He's got a lot of room. Tough pass. He had the sideline in front of him, didn't he?
Yeah, and one of the things I've noticed, the receivers all stop when he starts. You know, and the thing you're supposed to do is you're supposed to keep moving and try to get open. And once he starts running, they kind of all stopped in their tracks, which that's the kind of guy I want to guard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. You know, the coaching axiom is if you're the deep receiver, you come back to the quarterback. If you're the short one, you take off and go to a sideline or get out of the way. But actually, I think he had plenty of chance to run for the first down there.
He did.
Just wanted to make the big play. It's not hard to figure out why. Escamilla pulls it out, tries to step up field. He never had really anywhere to go. Nice job out there both by...
Well, he should have ran the last play.
Yeah. Garrett McGraw and Michael Cadlick just had him secured. So that's a three and out for the offense for the Wildcats. And it's been basically since the opening drive, they've been shut out. Nice job by the Lambkins D. As you said, with the momentum squarely on one side right now, you could we could have a running clock coming anytime, just as the way you feel the game is going. And they're not going to call anything on that one. That was, I think he did a nice job acting on it. Referee walked up on it. This time they rushed him. I thought he hit his foot. We just had the angle.
It looked like he did.
Yeah. I think actually it could have been, you know, the punter could have just said it's like I'm protecting my leg and pulled it back, and that's the hardest thing to do, to leave yourself out there exposed as not natural as an athlete. So ball downfield, though.
And we saw that last night, how not natural that is.
Yeah, it's you don't want to do that. Yeah, 27 yard line, first and 10 now for a red hot offense. They've scored 35 unanswered points since giving up points on that touchdown on the opening drive to the Wildcats. Lambkins have come alive.
Well, again, they scored 42 last week. And there's Leone, who's had three touchdown pass last week.
And that one, there's just no room for that play there. Sometimes you try the short side because they've overshifted, but no problem there whatsoever. Brings up still pretty much second and 10. And Martin, just maybe a half a foot loss on the mark. Lang in motion, Erickson pulls it down, throws the out. Now, I don't know if that was supposed to go to shore or was it going outside to Leone. They both kind of look like they're in the line. That wasn't run the way you want to draw it up, is it?
No. Makes you wonder if one was supposed to
keep
go
going.
And one stay.
Because Erickson turned and fired it right away, no hesitation.
So what I don't understand, what makes that okay? Is that because he hasn't said set?
Yeah, well, none of those offensive linemen, you know, to put their hand on the ground. They're starting from
the... Oh, so it's once you put your hand on the ground.
Yeah, you put your hand on the ground, this one's going to come back.
Got the first down, but...
Yeah, we're very close to it, but we have the early flag called out there by the referee, and he's going to go ahead and let the cat out of the bag, which everybody knows. Yeah, no, as long as the linemen are in their upright stance, they can go in the crouch and still raise up. So that will negate a pretty good run by Erickson.
And the air is out of this place right now. The excitement is over. You can tell the crowd is pretty much enjoying the evening, cheering when something big happens right now. Student section is still quite full. Big day of football here. Saw Poudre go out to a big early lead, then hold on to stop a hard-charging Fountain Fort Carson.
That's one of those games that Pooter's got to be happy it didn't go five more minutes.
Mm-hmm. Erickson standing in his end zone, looking downfield. He's got to get rid of it. He got a nice peel-back block. He's got a ton of room. Fires one too high. He had short wide open that time. That was the easiest throw he's had in a while.
It is, missed him. And he could have run probably back up to the 25. He only had one guy out there that could tackle him.
Yeah. So fourth down on a play that they needed about 30. They needed to get out to the 37-yard line. They're going to be punting from their end zone. Ball spotted on the 9. As the godfather, Kevin Westhouse, used to say, they need to go to about 3rd and Laporte. Pretty good punt. It's going to hit the ground, too. That's one of those you got to kind of come up and get. You can't let that bounce. Ball spotted right near midfield. Timothy Daniels back there, number 80 on the punt, and that's just one of those. It's tough to say, but you want to come running up there. You want to take that ball. You just save maybe 8-10 yards. Either way, though, good field position now. This is the time that, you know, Greeley's got to get something going. Ball run right side. Yackey gets outside. One good stiff arm there. A couple good misses there right now. They got to get to the party. Here come a lot of purple jerseys, but not after about a 10-yard gain.
First and 10 now.
Fake second back through again. Yackey gets the outside. That's that little trap play. The cross buck gets downside near the 20.
Great block.
Yeah, it really was.
And Greeley West offensively, they're still playing hard. I mean, they're...
Well, there's a bunch of athletes there that want to make plays. You know, they've got the explosiveness. We've talked about that. And you have a chance to make a play. They're going to do it. 3:25 clock running here at French Field. Second game of the day. David Hoslong, Randy McCoy, Abby Block, our camera person tonight, doing a great job. Yackey bouncer on the outside. Saw the headlines on the far sideline. Hadn't had a chance to throw his flag in a while. He decides to get it in the action.
Well, and I think Greeley Central needs to realize that, you know, they're hurting their defense by the incomplete passes because they're giving more time to Fort Collins, so they need to get their running game going. And
yeah, you got to be balanced.
Give your defense a break.
We do know now, like I said, the softball seasons have pretty much wound down there. Regionals will be announced on Monday. We hope that the Lambkins down here, along with the Lobos, the Sabercats, and then the Impalas, all have a chance to make it into the state tournament. That'd be quite the feat, all four teams locally.
Oh,
yeah. Bounced up there, had a chance, and that one was just, that's the first one we've seen, I think, Camillus really just kind of lobbed the ball out there. He did put the pace on that ball like he had.
Well, and his receiver coming from the other side was open. Probably would have went in for 6. So, but you know, you got to make split-second decisions.
Yeah, you got to commit. These guys are high school kids, and they don't have the view we've got either. That's a little tougher to see, but Escamilla, that's the first one I've seen him kind of just try to really put a touch on instead of really gun it. Once again, big pressure right up the middle, nowhere to go. Corey Lang on the tack, on the tackle, along with number 56 getting in there was Schumann. So both the captains there met at the quarterback. Under 2.5 to play here in the third quarter. So after a couple of big plays, Greeley Central is starting to move backwards again. Third to about 20. They need to get to the 11, inside the 11-yard line. Twin receivers in the near sideline, tight end left. Keeping Yackey in just a block, but Escamilla, he's already dropped his eyes.
There's nobody coming back to him either.
Yeah, well, and like I said, they keep running. They got a lot of deep patterns, and nobody, there's, you know, what you talked about, they run downfield. But what made me kind of smile there at the same time, it was like, and all at once, the umpire and the referee both threw their flags, same place, same time, saw the same hold. I would probably take that one just to get them, you know, out of even field goal range or even desperation into the end zone range. Because the spot foul and it moves it back. Yeah, they are going to decline it, so they'll put fourth down. Oh. Yep. There was two calls. There was two different holding penalties. Had their choice, so they took the one that's further back, of course. And the ball is going to be marked clear back across midfield. They've got to get to the 11-yard line for a first down. They're on their own 48. So if you do the math, they need to gain 41 yards on this play. So Escamilla back out, single back, no one with him, trips right side into the sideline, free rush coming, trying to set up the screens, got him underneath, but one tackler made the miss. But I'll tell you, the play there, though.
Quarterback hung in there, didn't he?
Yeah,
he
really did. Well, and I just want to get, you know, Steven Brewer bombing that time. He was on the rush. He bit into the fake, went back there, but turned around and hustled back and made the tackle coming back from the rush position. So, I mean, just a great hustle play there. Yeah, and we'll see this time if back for the rugby-style punt. One hopper still on the ground. They got a chance. He's just trapped back there now. Going to try. Actually, what a great job of stepping up and kicking it. Now, he got hit. But when you turn into, you start running, you're a running back. You are no longer a punter. And what a great job. He kicked that ball low drive, got down to the 10-yard line or so.
That's one of the best plays from a punter I've seen in a long time.
That really was. He had the presence of mind to pick it up and keep his, got his eyes downfield real quick and found just a sliver between two Lambkins and kicked it.
And it wasn't like there was just one guy on him.
No.
I mean, the you know, the levee had busted.
Yeah. Well, I think he figured out that if I get rid of it, they won't come after me. It's like, I'll get rid of this
what
now.
Do they want from me? Oh, they want the ball. Well, let me get rid of it.
I'll figure that out. Erickson under center now. I formation behind him. Say deep in their own territory. McGraw goes around right side. Just falls behind his blockers. Keeps pushing along.
Leone is limping.
Yeah, I think there was a pretty good pileup over there and earlier and had to get a couple guys. I mean, there's no lack of effort out here tonight, either team going on, but I agree with you. What the Wildcats offense does is tough for them to play defense. Quick little run to the outside there. You got a chance to make the corner. And a great jet sweep that time. Michael Cadlick turned it upfield. And you got to believe in that. You got to just assume there's no defensive end's going to step across and take your head off. But he took off and hit it full speed.
Bonham made a touchdown-saving tackle right there, and that'll be the end of the quarter, I believe.
Yes, it will. Time is counting down, so they'll spot, change or set. We're after three quarters of play here at French Field. The Lambkins lead 35-7 over the visiting Wildcats.
Who wants more peas?
Go away.
Oh, Daddy hates pop-up ads.
Go away.
Hashtag dinner time.
Scroll forward.
Shoot selfie.
No.
Selfie.
Scroll forward.
Delete selfie.
Go away.
Send picture.
Bookmark.
No.
Go away.
No, post photo.
Scroll up. Scroll forward.
Hashtag gravy.
Faster.
Faster.
The First Bank mobile app. Technology has never been so easy.
Lambkins ball.
Erickson pulls it back, takes up field. Boy, it's disintegrating into a penalty about every other play now. I think the mental edge is kind of going away. It's 35-7. After about an 8-yard run, referee sees a personal foul against the Lambkins.
Wonder how that works.
It had to be a block. Somebody, you know, cutting somebody downfield.
Well, you don't see that very often on it, but usually they call the
chop block downfield. You know, just coming back and a defenseless player kind of could turn around. We won't get that kind of report. But either way, they just moved him back. Reset the clock. It starts. Lambkins definitely in control of the game. 35-7. Fake the ball and jet sweep. Erickson steps up the middle. He's got a foot race right down the seam. He gets the outside, cross midfield down to the 40, and heads inside the 40 down to about the 33-yard line, 32 marked by the linesman. What a great run.
And makes Coach Rice very happy running out of bounds there instead of taking a hit.
No, you don't need to prove anything there. You just dug
Not
your team
up 35-7.
Yeah, you just dug your team out of a second and 20-some yard hole and
easily been the player of the game tonight, yeah. Erickson.
Yeah. Quickly back over the ball. As soon as I say that, everybody stands up, looks the sideline for a play. Just a great way to keep the defense from being able to substitute. McGraw follows up the field in the ISO. Gain of about 5. Pile all meets there. But the band is still rocking. They've not lost the edge. Got to give credit to the guys up front today, too. The Lambkins line, both sides, tons of pressure on the Escamilla, the quarterback for the Wildcats, and just done a nice job of ring there, taking it downfield. Goes to Leone. Leone does a nice job of playing defense, didn't he?
He did, and I thought he was going to bat it up to himself, but ball needed to be just a little bit higher.
Yeah, a little deeper, had to get it down in the end zone a little bit more. He was behind him and a much smaller player on him, but the corner did the great job. You get underneath the bigger player and you stay there. You just fit inside him and don't let him get any separation where he can make a play. So third and about 6. Play call coming in from the sideline again. Back judge hasn't made a count yet. Got to give the officials some credit, too. This is their second game of the day. Oh, easy handoff on the side. McGraw just motoring down and goes out inside the 15-yard line. I think the pushing is getting a little easier now. They're starting to wear down that defense. And to your point earlier, they've spent a lot of time on the field. Now they've got a few kids that go both ways, and that's just the fatigue starts setting in. A lot more energy to play defense than it is to play offense. So first and 10 now, ball in about the 15-yard line of the Wildcats. Erickson under center, turns, gives straight iso play. McGraw goes straight forward. Pyle moves down close to the 10-yard line.
You know, we have not seen their top runner today, tonight. I don't know if he's hurt or... McGuire, number 9, mm-hmm. has been their top rusher behind Erickson. I see the number down
there. Sideline, so just one of those games we're not needing to be in. No back. Erickson back by
himself.
He
was running every play earlier in the season.
Yeah. Keeper play by Erickson straight up the middle. Makes one move. Bounce off another.
He's going
to
go in
the end zone.
Boy. And, yeah. That is an athlete, let me tell you what.
Well, it just took that great moment. We see that same play run so well by James Campbell, too, and Erickson runs it just as well. And he kind of picks his way through there and kept going forward.
He may be the best football player in town this year. I mean,
score down at Cherry Creek. Cherry Creek still proving why they're one of the tops in the state. They lead 42-7, which is coincidentally the score we have here. But when you get to go out and compete against these schools, like we talked about before, when you've got upwards of more than 1,000 more students, that's what you end up with in the numbers. That is such a difference maker, picking from that many more kids to fill out a football team. Literally twice as big as the schools up here. So we've got 9 1/4 left here, and if Les Greeley...
Got a pretty good coach, too,
yeah.
Cherry Creek.
Yeah, he's traveled around well, hasn't he? Everywhere he's been, he's proven that he can do it. And Dave Logan is one of those Colorado treasures, born and raised, star at CU, ended his career in the NFL with the Broncos. He's won state championships at a couple of different schools, and I wouldn't be surprised if Cherry Creek had him in the championship game 2 years ago. They'll get it done one of these days there, I imagine, too. And they go for the pooch kick. Nice job. It's still on the ground. They didn't get the call. I think Greeley Central did cover it. So up 42-7, the onside pooch kick comes out.
Perfect time for it.
Yeah. Confidence in your defense, though, is certainly to be warranted because they've played lights out. Like I said, they gave up the initial touchdown in the opening drive after a long, long kickoff return. And it really wasn't a drive. It was only about 30 yards. But since then, they have shut down the Greeley Central Wildcats. Escamilla back to throw again, trying to get away, fires it upfield, incomplete.
Well, he's going to get tired of number 56. That number 56 has been back in his grill
Kyle Schulman all
night.
Well, there's reasons why McCoy and Schulman, Lang, Cadlick, they're all captains, but because their effort just doesn't slow down, does it?
No, and again, 56 has been every play. He's right there.
Yeah. Not many substitutions either on that Lambkin defense yet. I mean, they don't have a deep bench. It's not a huge squad. This can be a back, fires down the middle, a little high. Nice grab, though. Goes up and catches it. Grab there by number 11, Bonham.
Schulman went right through a double team. Yeah.
So 3rd and 3 here now.
He's got what we like to call in the business a good motor.
Yes, he does. Yeah, he does. That's a great way to put it. You're going to get all him every time. Had to have somebody get off the field for the Wildcats. Got the receiver in.
Ooh.
And flips through the hands of the with first down yardage there.
And again, the quarterback for Greeley Central does not have time to throw a deep ball.
Yeah, no, there's no timing pattern that's going to exist that gives them a 30-yard throw, is there? You're exactly right. So 8:37 left here in the fourth quarter. I'd like to thank again all of our sponsors, Pedersen Toyota, First Bank, Schrader Oil, and our banner sponsor this year, GoJo Sports. 4-down linemen. And actually, before the snap, the Lambkins took a timeout. So the timeout in the field, we'll be back after this message.
Wherever it is you want to go, all you need to see is the next 200 feet.
That's how life unfolds. A leap of faith. Even if you can't see it, your destination is out there. So just keep going, and you'll get there. 200 feet at a time. The Corolla. Toyota. Let's go places.
Give him your cell number.
Well, he called me the other night, and I don't think he understood. I was in South Carolina, and it was 11 o'clock at night.
So, well, yeah.
I mean, I didn't answer the phone, but...
Back here in fourth quarter action. Fourth down, Wildcats are going for it. I think it's the make or break play of the game right now for them. 8:35 left. They give the ball up in midfield, and the way Lambkin's offense has been going. Fires it downfield, he's got a man wide open. Catches it, it's gonna run down inside the 10-yard line. There's the one timing pattern we've seen, Randy. That was the one time the Lambkins did not. They just tried to stay in place and not put the pressure on. And Escamilla, to his credit, throws a laser.
Man, that was a beautiful pass.
That really was.
A little too late.
The first time they dialed back the pressure, and I think that was number 80, Timothy Daniels. And he caught it right on the fly. And a good job of just making the tackle from behind by the DB for the Lambkins. It's going to be a fake, goes outside, nobody on him. It's going to be a foot race to the corner. One he wasn't going to win, though. Great job of just accelerating, getting out there and making the play. Michael Field, 35. So second and nine, clock running, 7.5 to play. Yackey goes up the middle, steps inside, and into the end zone. Touchdown, Wildcats. So their first score since the first minutes, the opening part of this game. But a nice drive. They go for it on fourth down, Randy. Get the big, big strike downfield, and then follow it up with a touchdown run.
And that's going to kind of ensure that this will not become a mercy rule game.
Yeah, you wouldn't think so. Well, it doesn't mean it couldn't happen with 3 minutes left, I guess. But, yeah, the game has been effectively over. But credit the Wildcats for keeping
for
the effort
to play.
Up.
Yeah. I want to wish all the folks out in Myrtle Beach a safe day tomorrow. They're got a hurricane warning. As many of you all know, I work out there quite a bit and have a lot of good friends.
Yeah. Hope everybody out that way, all up and down the coast.
Yeah, I flew back home Wednesday night. So, shout out to all my really good friends out there. Hopefully, they're okay tomorrow.
Final score down, and Cherry Creek ends up winning 42-7 over Fossil Ridge.
So I guess that answers a few things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a tough place to go play. And then Cherry Creek, obviously, and Eagle Crest, too. Both are, everything is advertised.
That's a beat-up Cherry Creek team, too. I think they were playing a running back
and
quarterback.
Running back quarterback, yeah. Yeah.
You know, once you create a winning tradition, good things happen. And Fossil Ridge is trying to do that. They certainly have taken some steps this year. But not that big a step yet.
No, there's still those gaps.
And Fossil Ridge's attendance enrollment's gone down, actually, in the last couple of years. So
Yeah, they were over 2,000, now down about 1,800, right around with Rocky and Poudre just below that. Onside kick attempt that time by the Wildcats bounces down. They had a shot at it.
Yeah, it was
covered by the Lambkins.
It was anybody's football there for a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one of those hair-raising plays in football because that ball could bounce and people are just flying along.
So we'll see if Fort Collins wants to run some time off the clock.
Still pretty much a lot of the starters in the game now across the way. 42-14 lead. Erickson hands off to outside. There are times McGuire catches the ball. He sprints upfield.
Again, earlier in the year, McGuire.
No. A lot of the carries. Led that way right up in front in fullback, Logan Gabbard. Done a nice job tonight just being the lead back. They've run a fair amount of ISO out of that I formation. Clock running under 7 to play. Second and about 5. Fullback give this time. Gabbard steps up field, runs right into defensive tackles. Fullbacks shouldn't go east-west. They definitely need to stick to north-south. And he turned and tried to get around the corner there. And just to, you know, you're so much closer to the line. You don't have that angle. It's tougher to do.
McGuire with 56 carries for 212 yards coming into this game. McGraw, 27 carries, 174. And Erickson, actually, 66 carries for 254. He's easily got 100 yards tonight, I believe. Along with a nice passing night as well.
Yeah. So third and 4. Erickson back throws, got the slant in. Ball batted down at the line of scrimmage. Nice job of just getting up in the air. Number 56 there for the Wildcats. He saw the ball coming. When you can't get to the quarterback, you know, and Pablo Juarez just smartly said, I can't get there. I'll get up and knock it down. So fourth down, up and.
Could try to get him to go offside,
yeah,
I believe.
Yeah, you got to see if they're going to set him up, see if they'll take the cheese. 5:55 left. They have punted out of these formations before, too. Back to throw, looks around, got the edge on the far side, fires it downfield, easy interception on the 20, 30-yard line, going all the way upfield. He's got the speed to go out the outside. It's going to be a pick six.
Yeah, that's not even close.
Yeah. I think a lot of Lambkins had kind of quit on the play. And when you
that boy ran a quick 60-yard
well,
spin.
Yes,
let
he
me
did.
Tell you what.
And I'll tell you, and Erickson got popped pretty good on the far side, too.
And he's getting popped pretty good too.
Yeah, right now there's a little tuition to be paid here on the sideline. Coach might not have thought he wanted him to do that. So all of a sudden, what was a blowout a minute ago is still fairly well in hand. But 5:39 left. Lambkins, I think they kind of just stopped mentally on the game because they certainly did on that play. Greeley Central was out there lining up for the extra point, and I think Lambkins forgot about there's one more play after the touchdown. Yackey back to kick, blocked, it's up in the air, and exits the field through the side of the end zone, so no good.
That's what they say, you look at Greeley Central, they have no shortage of athletes.
Yeah, their size and their speed over there too, it just, I say
that's the quickest pick six I think I've seen in high school.
He had an alley, didn't he? Because he saw it, he just put the hammer down.
And I don't think anybody touched him. They didn't slow him down. If they did touch him, it was to
they didn't get much
high
hand
five out. Him or whatever.
Yeah,
but
No, I think that was one of those fourth down plays where they were just kind of trying to figure what was going on. None of the Lambkins. I mean, after the pick was made, there were still 6-7 guys that almost thought it was like he must have, you know, he was going to down it or something.
Well, I guess you look at it, you know, like a punt. Either way, all of a sudden it's 42-20, and like you said, it's not necessarily.
Well, it's tough, and we've said this before in every sport, girls and boys both. There's 16, 17, and 8-year-olds out there, 18-year-olds out there. And you just you go at a higher level for a while, and then that edge goes away, and we've seen that here, you know, late in the second quarter, a little bit for the Lambkins, and certainly here in the last couple of minutes with a couple of plays, you know, made by, you know, a team that just won't give up, and credit to Greeley Central for that. And they had an onside kick last time, so you got to expect that again.
And, you know, we watched Poudre.
Yes.
You know, in this very day.
So Yackey to kick off. This time the onside is going to go to the near sideline.
Boy.
They were offsides, I think. Yeah. Jumped the gun a little bit. And they had it set up, too.
You just see Greeley Central's body language a lot different.
The Wildcats for the offsides on the onside kick attempt were moved back 5 yards, kicking from the 35. And that one is not going to make it the 5 yards. One of the Lambkins touched it.
Yeah, but the Lambkins touched it, and I think Greeley Central got it. He's got the ball.
Yeah.
As we saw in an NFL game last week, that doesn't sometimes matter.
Just as
although
good.
There's Central players pointing the wrong way, but
yeah. Yeah.
And what happened, folks, if you didn't see that down in the scrum, is the ball only went about 4 yards, but the Fort Collins Lambkin touched it,
yeah.
So that made it okay for the Wildcat to pick it up.
Yeah, you always think it's a live ball, and it's tough to tell a return team. If it doesn't get to you, stop. Don't touch it. It can sit there. You can leave it go. So this can be back to throw again. Looks downfield. Gets flushed. Runs to his left. It's going to come back with a holding penalty. He's looking for a place to go out of bounds and does. And no sense running that far.
There's really no reason to hold on that because he was already out of dodge. But you don't know that when you're in the middle of the...
Yeah, you're not facing the quarterback. You're the lineman. So 5:26 to play here. Time is kind of ground to a halt. Spot foul, so that marching it off will take it back to the 27-yard line. After the offensive play, the clock will wind. Running down now. Trips to the top of your screen. Single receiver at the bottom. Escamilla rolls his right. Tries to find somebody in the slot. Almost picked off. Great break on the ball. Had it in his hands and just didn't secure it. But a nice play. Shea Wind there. That had been one of those if he had held on to it, too. He had the sideline.
23 to go for the Wildcats. With
5:05
left in
the game. So second down. Ball's going to be snapped at the 27-yard line. They need to get across midfield, basically at the 49-yard line of the Lambkins for a first down. Snap off the right. Nice job by Escamilla just to get the snap. Looks around, has to move. Looks downfield, fires the ball over the middle. He's got a man wide open, first down and out of bounds.
And there's a, well, he's fortunate he did not fall down.
Yeah.
Or that'd have been another 15.
And yeah, a little late on the.
Well, he was 5 yards out of bounds still.
Out.
Again, the only reason he didn't call is because young man didn't fall down.
Say credit to the Wildcats, they are not giving up. I'll tell you what, they're making plays. That's coming in. Still guys throw to the linemen are working hard. Steps inside the pocket that time, goes back around, fires it just to get it out of his hands. Because he had Shulman, like he said, he's been in his kitchen all night long, hasn't he? And Shulman and number 65, Jack Pedersen, they're going to sleep good tonight. They have worn out that middle of the line. And just, I mean, it's been a great effort by both sides, but they've won more of them than they've lost. And pressure has been on Escamilla all night long. Screen looks like he's set up. Now he's got no one to go. He's going to run right back into pressure and be dragged down. Loss of about 12 yards on the play back to the 46-yard line.
Quarterback stopped by Popoli, led by Garrett McGraw. Brings up third down and 10. Excuse me, they're getting long now for the Wildcats.
If you're Fort Collins, that clock can't run fast enough.
Yeah, you're trying to keep it moving, and after a long sack like that, they're only rushing three. Here comes the screen pass set up the outside. Yackey's got it, turns back inside. Can be tackled just short of the 48-yard line. Gets across midfield. Nice hustle play coming back up there. Both number 34 was Jace Whitey, and then number six there was Garrett McGraw. And they did a nice job. They got to the outside and forced him back in, didn't they? He had no chance of getting out of bounds. 3.5 to play here in the game. 42-20. Lambkins, you know, they've gone in great spurts where they played it. Now, if you look on your camera, it's tough to see. The defensive backs are all so deep. They're about 10, 15 yards. And this has got to be an easy pick there because he just threw it down the middle, and they're sitting back there just praying on it. Going downfield.
Pass intercepted by Cam Turbin.
Cameron Turman just playing center field there. That ball was thrown down the middle. I mean, he's trying to make a play. I get it. But that was just that you're playing right into the defense there. I was just saying there, I'll sit back at 10 to 15 yards so everything's happening in front of them, Randy, and that's not a hard play to make.
That's kind of like that was Jay Cutler-ish there where it's kind of falling in love with your arm too much.
No, that's a very good way to put it. Yeah, you have to be patient no matter what. Not one play is not worth 22 points, and they need to put it down there. So I think now you're just going to see a steady diet of runs, and Collins could run the clock out here.
New quarterback in, number three.
And he takes off as a great fake, pulls it back. It's Michael Hemmers, sophomore.
Michael Remmers has the ball.
Or Remmers.
Print was too big. I couldn't read it.
He's a quarterback, a wide receiver, and a defensive back. 5'7", buck 44.
You are not a one-trick pony on Eric Rice's teams.
Everybody has two positions if you look on their roster.
Nope. You got to play both ways. And, you know, and until you get to the bigger 5A schools, that's kind of the norm. You know, but even the bigger 5A schools, a lot of your best athletes will play both ways. It's tougher for linemen, but... Ball given on the sweep that time. Heads up field, first down yardage, and Moore heads to the end zone. Gets to the corner and doesn't make it. Gets run out about the 1 yard line. So the jet sweep goes to Jackson Shore, who's had a couple of great catches tonight, one for a long touchdown. Showed some nice footwork there and in speed, but still got caught at the 1 yard line. So this game is pushing 2.5 hours ish.
In dead silence.
Yeah, there is. The interest level is waned. Big night here in the city, though. CSU's homecoming weekend, Fort Collins homecoming weekend. Lambkins are in the I formation.
I get a day off tomorrow.
fly right in the end zone. Nice surge by the line. Everybody was into the end zone before the running back even touched the ball. So 6 points, Lambkins score, 2:28 left in the game, 48-20, PAT pending.
Lambkins have scored 91 points the last two games. I believe they had 42. A little delay reaction there from the public address announcer.
Yep.
Up and good for the extra point.
We're running out of things to say. We're trying to, you know what? I mean, you can't say enough about the effort Greeley sent. They're just outmanned, and whatever mistakes they've made, Lambkins have made them pay. But once again, a well-coached team, a great effort tonight, both offensively and defensively by the Lambkins. So an excellent homecoming victory. Lead 49-20 right now. There's 2:28 to play. That may take another 25 to 30 minutes. But who's counting?
Yeah. Would hope to maybe see some reserves in for Greeley Central. But they're in a similar boat as Fort Collins. They do not have a large squad.
Yeah. They've got probably about 25 kids over there on the bench.
Just a comparison to
talking about, you know, like the larger squads. I mean, Eagle Crest yesterday brought up about 75, 80 kids alone, and knowing Cherokee Trail and Cherry Creek, these other schools down there with 3,000 plus, Grandview, you know, just to name just a few, you know, they've got squads of 95 to 100 kids. Squib kick bounces down about the 16-yard line, taken by one of the upbacks. Trying to find a place to run, spins away from one tackle, gets the outside tackle from behind at about the 36-yard line.
Nice run there for number 20. That's Dylan Chartier.
Brings the ball out past the 30-yard line. Where the Wildcats will have it first and 10. 2:20 to left. They trail by 29 points. So, you know, now they're just playing for trying to get things done. There's nobody covering over Yaki there on the slot. He gets outside, takes reception, walks away from one tackle, makes it a foot race down the sideline. He's going to get pushed out, or actually didn't go down out of bounds, and goes to the 22-yard line.
Yaki's had a pretty good game, actually.
Yes, he has. He's a competitor. You've got to love his effort. I mean, you can't say anybody over there with Greeley Central. I mean, they clearly there's, you know, they're not the better team tonight, but their effort hasn't lacked. Escamilla rolls his right. Not much pressure coming up. Fields got time to look. Throws the end zone. He's got a man wide open. Touchdown.
And that's your basic two-play drive.
Yeah, the line judge. The far side, that linesman pretty much took the play off, too. I mean, he had sideline duty there, but he was still about the 15-yard line when the catch was made. And
the Lambkins took it off, too, because they were all just kind of looking at each other. So I'm not sure if they forgot there's still 2 minutes left.
Yep.
But now they look up and
2-point conversion coming here now. Good chance to practice. No backs. Yeah. Escamilla rolls his right. Just tried to fit one in there. Knocked down. Nice defensive play. So no good there. Good job just reaching across by Garrett McGraw.
And this is what happens with your stats as well, because a lot of times you can pile up the stats in what they call in the business garbage time.
Yeah.
But you still have to execute the plays. And Greeley Central has done that, even though this game was decided a long time ago. Well, thank you for joining us tonight, both games. Been quite a journey, hasn't it?
Yep, long day's night.
See the Lambkins there in their
kickoff
silver
home.
And gold and purple.
Appreciate those jerseys tonight.
Yes, boy, you can see those numbers great.
Read the numbers. We've both teams will compliment that. That is generally not the case we have here. Congrats to those Greeley Central parents that have come over here tonight and stayed there to cheer on their kids. Pooch kick. Bouncing down along the hash, taken by the Lambkins. Tries to get the right side. Cadillac turns up field and runs out about the 45s. Yep, that's just a good idea. Minute 47 left here to play.
Unless you want the clock to... Well, I guess it was going to stop anyway, wasn't it?
Yeah, kickoff on special teams. You're getting jaded.
We're sorry, folks. This is just
us being
couple
tired.
Of games in two nights that...
I'm starting to get my mail here in French Field. Is that it? Stop. That's it.
The struggle is real.
Yeah. Down with it. Erickson back in at quarterback. Hands off to McGraw around the right side. A little of intensity lacking. Somebody got yelled at and the starters are all back in. And did stay in bounds. Clock running under a minute and a half to play.
If you say...
Pretty close. I think somebody said, yes, he was.
Yes, he was.
49-26.
That official said, you are in bounds.
Right there. Look good enough. He's on the right sideline to get the call. Waiting down to the back jug, starts his count. And, of course, we got a penalty. Two-minute motion. Same time.
And that stops the clock.
Well, until they reset it. Offensive penalties, you don't get, otherwise you'd just be doing it on purpose, just to get at us. Clock's wound again now, starts it all over. 53 to play here.
So they really should be able to.
This would be the last play.
Two victory formations.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they could go under center and kneel on this one now. 36 to play. Toss play to the right side. Graw turns it back inside. Still going forward. Sweet plays take a little bit of time under 30. That will do it. So the coaches get to take their headset on the sidelines. Players going to start migrating to the middle and give a chance to go through and congratulate the other side for their effort. And that's going to be the last play here at French Field on a 3-game-in-2-days run for us at Stream and Sports. Thanks for tuning in and watching us here with Poudre School District Athletics. Final score here at French Field as the clock goes to 3-0, 49-26. Lambkins win over the visiting Greeley Central Wildcats. I had to pause. Knew it was coming, but a homecoming victory. What a great way to celebrate it. Friday Night Lights. Congratulations, Lambkins. So we will see you next week. So for Randy McCoy and Abby Block, our camera person tonight, I'm David Haase. Thank you once again for watching Stream and Sports.
Poudre School District High School Football, live on Stream and Sports Northern Colorado, has been brought to you by Schrader Oil. Fuel your day. By Pedersen Toyota, everything cars made easy. And by First Bank. Visit any of our convenient locations in Northern Colorado.